Overexplaining hurts a ton for new players, as long as they listen. Yeah, I hope so. Hello, by the way. I will try to focus on explaining it a bit. If I can, if my opponent is not too strong, I can do it. But let's see. Yeah, he got one belt and 325, which is basically nothing. More people should watch this. It helps because I could imagine when there's some new player and he's watching replays of some better player, he doesn't really maybe understand why this player is doing what he does, moving away from the opponent, for example, even if the opponent is slow. And to explain the reasons behind that, yeah, it gives maybe some nice insights.
The match is starting.
Okay, so what I try to do now is, of course, to choose the good spot. I heard him take the sniper, so I won't go there, because right now I just don't focus on killing him, but to use the time to get myself an advantage before the first armor spawns. I also prevented the shock from him, which is a really good weapon to control certain areas, because you can combo it. And now I delay. He went directly for the 50, and now I delay the armor a bit. Try to deny the next shock again. And just secure my advantage right now. He doesn't have the shock. I don't have to be too concerned about him blocking me away from certain parts of the map. And now I can just make use of my advantage, my armor advantage, and my weapon advantage to kill him. Now that I delayed the armor, I had the opportunity to get to armor in time before he could pick it up. And I shouldn't miss this frag here. What I could have done is to go to the 50 directly after armor to have it nicely lined up. But in this situation, I just preferred to get myself a frag advantage. Armor again. I know that 50 is delayed now, so I don't go there. Rather go to shock. And now, some seconds later. So he mistimed the 50. I knew it was delayed, but he thought it was up. So this is a good example of why you should be aware of the timings at every time. Armor is up again. I picked it up. In the next armor circle, I will try to get the 50 and the armor aligned. Just that I don't spend too much time wasting here at the 50 area. Oh, armor is up. Now I forgot it, but he's out of position for it. Okay, I wanted to delay it anyway, so I go for 10 seconds, which means it will spawn at 40 seconds. 10 and 40 seconds. And now, as you see, the 50 and the 100 is nicely aligned. Perfect timing on the belt, and he doesn't have a chance, basically. He could go for the 50. Okay, so I delayed the armor timing to 10, so it's spawning at 40 now. And now I just go grab the 50 because it's aligned. Belt is at 0, it's really easy to remember. I will read your messages after this game because this is a nice flow right here. So armor is coming up. He's at 10 HP. I could kill him, but I again prefer to pick the 50. Belt is coming up and I couldn't delay the shock for him. And now I have a look if he picked up the shock, and he did. So, but I made the best trade I could get here. Armor again at 40. Shock is up, I go to 50. Maybe deny him from the shock by scaring him off with some shock balls. He didn't get a hit scan weapon now, which is very nice. And in 10 seconds the next armor spawns. Also the shock will spawn any second now. Okay, but armor is prior number one. So again, shock is up. I scare him away a bit, take 50, grab shock and go for belt. And now maybe he's at belt and I'm a bit late, so I miscalculated that. But I can still kill him, which is very nice. Now I need to remember belt is at 54. So it's not at 0 exactly. Armor again, 40. Scare him off, 50, and shock. Oh, he's stuck. Okay, luckily, I know the armor timing. I still have 100 HP. Okay, this is maybe enough to kill him. Yeah. So he didn't have the shock. And I still got the armor, which is pretty nice. And I forgot about the belt. So belt is at 49. Which is still good, because there are 10 seconds in between the armor and the belt, which gives me enough time to move. And now it's getting a bit complicated, because I have a new armor timing and a new belt timing. So belt timing is 54. And I picked up... the armor at 38, I think. Oh. Okay, so in 5 seconds armor will spawn right now, I think. And now I have to take care. I don't want to get in line of sight, because he could kill me in one shot. Belt is at 50 exactly, I think. So, yeah. Armor at 34. Okay, 32. I still have 10 seconds until armor spawns. So, okay. Shock is not coming up, so I just go for armor. But I tried to make the most use out of my 10 seconds, which I had. And I thought I could grab the shock, maybe. Still some seconds up for armor. You could keep in mind that you only really need 5 seconds or so to get over the map, so you don't have to be really early for the items. Oh, I'm not hitting. I'm still in a very safe spot, even if he hits me sometimes. As long as I can grab the armor. Okay, last belt coming up in a few seconds. And the last armor is up. Didn't pick the right spawn for this, but maybe I can still deny him. Yeah. And I think he didn't get one armor in this game, which is pretty nice.
9, 8, 7, 6, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You have one.
Yeah. Yeah, he got 125 and 150. And I got 17 50s, 1800 shields, and 9 belts. I think you have to explain really good. So when he asks me, well, what could he do? I think when you are in the defensive position and out of control, you have to be much more situational. Because when you are in control, you have your short-term goals, which you want to follow. Which is timing, especially, or yeah, most of the part it's just timing. These are your objectives when you are in control. But when you are out of control, you cannot follow a routine, and you have to be really tricky and situational in what you're doing. You should always examine the situation you're in and try to just not die, basically. This is your main goal, don't die. And prevent as much damage as possible. Yeah.